Dear conference participants, I am Tetiana Kovaliuk and I present to your attention the report of the topic Analysis Streaming Video Content and Generation Relevant Contextual Advertising. This is the content of the presentation on slide 2. The relevance of the topic is determined by reasons which are shown in the slide. The relevance of using contextual advertising is determined by the following factors. While watching videos, online movie theaters and video services are the users, a variety of advertising that does not correspond to the content of the video and therefore not relevant. Such advertising is not interesting to the viewer and therefore does not generate expected revenue for advertisers. Therefore, advertising search the content of which corresponds to the content of the video and may interest the viewer is an important task. The purpose of this work is to increase the efficiency and usability of algorithm for real-time video stream analysis and finding advertisements in accordance with the content of the video stream. To achieve this purpose, it is necessary to solve the following tasks. To analyze the content, the current state and features of streaming video analysis, evaluate and visibility of using these approaches. To develop methods and algorithms for analyze and streaming video and generate contextual advertising. To develop software that implements the above algorithm. The authors have studied many relative works. Some works are shown on the slide. The author proposed the following steps for solving this problem. In the first stage, the video is Turing board and the obtained frames are analyzed by searching for the main object using image and computer vision algorithm. In the second stage, speech analyzing and recognizing of the video track and audio track and searching for keywords in the resulting text is performed. In the third step, the algorithm analyzing the video metadata and find the keyword in them. In the fourth stage, search for ads that are as close as possible to the content of the video stream based on the data received about the object. The scheme of algorithm is shown on the slide. Input data is presented as a video stream. Frame analysis, metadata and audio analysis are performed in parallel. After that, the advertisement search is performed. In the first stage, pattern recognition algorithm from video stream frames is performed. The algorithm implements such task. Object contour recognition using Prewitt algorithm. Found perceptual hashes of object in video frame uses the AP hash algorithm. Find common object by comparing hashing using the Hamming distance. Recognize common objects using the computer vision methods. As a result, we have K objects on the basis of which we can search video advertising. Uh, Such slide present object contour recognition method using Prewitt operator. Sliding mass as a filter is a square of 3x3 matrix corresponding to the pixel group of the original image. Each pixel with coordinates x, y is calculated as a sum of the product of the filter coefficients by the corresponding pixel values in the area covered by the filter mass. The example is shown in picture and in Formula 1. If some differences in brightness are in the image, then derivatives of the first and second order are used as a difference of the value of adjacent image elements and a difference of adjacent value of the first derivatives. This is the formula 2 and 3. The calculation of the first derivatives of the digital image is based on discrete approximation of the two-dimensional gradient. The gradient of the image can be calculated by determining the value of the partial derivatives. To implement the formula 7, we use the Prewitt operator described by mask in formula 9. Using the Prewitt operator in the gradient formula, we get images from frames and show only the contours of the objects. These contours allow us to highlight the area in the frames where the desired objects are located. To search for similar objects on the found contours, you can use frequency analysis of image. High frequencies provide detail, while low frequencies determine the structure of the image. The task of comparing images is to calculate the hash values of the images and calculate the Hamming distance between them. The smaller is the Hamming distance, the more similar are the image data. We consider a hash based on discrete Gaussian transform, which is a type of Fourier transform. The discrete Gaussian transform allows us passing from spatial representation of the image to a spectral representation and backing. See the formula 10. Then having the image in the form of a square matrix, we can obtain its two-dimensional cosine transformation as a formula 13. To build a perceptual hash using DCT, develop an algorithm in 6 steps. To search for objects that will determine the content of an advertising message relevant to the video stream, the operation of classifying the found common object in frames is performed. It is required to construct an algorithm capable of classifying arbitrary objects from the original set. We use a linear classifier according to the support vector machine methods. The main idea of the support vector machine method is to convert all the original vector into a space of high dimension and the search for separating the hyperplane with a maximum gap in the space. Two parallel hyperplans are constructed on both sides of the hyperplan, separating the classes. A separating hyperplan maximizes the distance to two parallel hyperplans. This slide illustrates the uses of support vector machine method. The stereo video audio track analysis consists of two parts. The first step is to recognize the audio speech of the video using an algorithm based on Mel-Frequency coefficient. The second step is to search for keywords in the resulting text based on the TF-IDF algorithm. A typical speech recognition scheme is presented in the slide. Fourier transform is processing input speech, then carried out the Mel-Cepstral analysis, perceptual weighting and time derivative. To next slide, describe the speech processing. This slide demonstrates algorithm. This uses the discrete Fourier transform to calculate the signal spectrum, Hamming window function to obtain values to smooth the value at the frame borders, discrete cosine transform to obtain Mel-Cepstral coefficients, machine learning method to recognize words from some dictionary. Log diagram for obtained Mel-Cepstral coefficients is demonstrated in such slide. The keywords that will be used to search for advertising corresponding to the video content should be identified in the recognized text from the audio track. To find keywords, we use the algorithm based on TF-IDF. The meaning of the term is directly proportional to the number of users of the term in the text and inversely proportional to the number of users of the term in other body text. So we have a follow expression for TF-IDF algorithm. And also the calculation of document relevance is based on the OKP BM25 functions based on a probabilistic model. See the formula 25. Summarizing the previously discussed, we describe the general algorithm for analyzing the video stream and search for relevant advertising. The current slide demonstrates the algorithm step by step. The description of the text case shows the practical use of the proposed algorithm for generated contextual advertising on a video stream. We demonstrate video stream fragment is an input. This video has the following metadata, a set of text with the frequency of their appearance is ordered. Video stream fragment is split into frames at 1 second intervals. Object with zero coefficients of significance in the video stream are detected. Speech recognition from audio track is performed and the text is received. Search for keywords in a given text and determine their weights. The result of selected contextual advertising from the set of all advertisement according to the criterion of maximizing the percentage of contextual objects to a plurality of objects from video frames, sound stream and video data is to advertise a link motion. Conclusion. The theoretical aspect of the problem of streaming video analysis are considered in the paper. Algorithms for video stream analysis and real time and finding advertisement in accordance with video content is presented. Real time video content analysis takes into account metadata, video frames, and audio. The following algorithms are used: Prewitt algorithm for object contour recognition, PH algorithm for finding similar object on video, support vector machine method for building the object's linear classifier, Mel-Frequency coefficient, and TF-IDF algorithm for speech recognition. A reference example is given. The result of which testify to the operability of the algorithm. Thank you for your attention.